Guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be doing a review of the brand new Natasha Denona Safari All Matte Eyeshadow Palette. This guy just released, so if you would like to hear my thoughts on it, then just keep watching. Alright, so just the basic facts about this palette. It is $129, the same price as all of the other palettes tend to range and pretty expensive. It is a limited edition. You can get it right now on Beautylish, Sephora, and of course the Natasha Denona website. It is a 15 pan palette of all matte eyeshadows. So the packaging of this guy is the same packaging of the Tropic palette, which if you don't know, that's the palette that she released before this a few months back. It's that same plastic magnetic thin packaging. This guy is a matte khaki green, which I love. I think it looks so sleek and so beautiful. It has all matte and these shiny letters, and of course says Natasha Denona and the Safari palette on it. Like the Tropic palette, if you go to the back, you see these little holes. If you stick like a needle or a bobby pin in here, it pops the eyeshadows out so that you can put them in a Z palette if you want the shadows out individually. You open it up, it reveals a huge mirror, which is great for travel, and of course the 15 eyeshadow shade. Personally, I love the packaging of this. I think it's really clever. It's very thin and very sleek, and I love the matte finish that it has on the outside. Now, according to the website, the purpose of this palette was to create the perfect matte eyeshadow palette. Natasha Denona has one of the best matte formulas out there. Her shimmer formulas have been struggling lately, they're a little bit inconsistent, but her matte eyeshadows have always been inconsistent. I'm just gonna be straight up right now, it has not fallen short at all. This is the same great, soft, creamy, buttery, blendable Natasha Denona matte formula. Now, the color scheme behind this palette is that it is Safari inspired, and what I think is really cool is she placed these colors in a way that it is easy for everybody to create a look. So you're supposed to be able to go either horizontally or vertically to create a look. Of course, as you can see, this top row is all of these blue gray cool tones, the second row is all of these warm tones, and the bottom row is rich reddish tones, which I think is really lovely, kind of the row I'm most excited about. So you can create a monochromatic look going this way, but you're also able to create a look going vertically. So she placed these three so that they can create an interesting look that isn't just monochromatic, which I think is very clever, and it makes it easier for everybody to use, honestly. It takes the thinking out of it. And of course, you don't have to go either horizontally or vertically to create a look. You can just kind of dip into whatever colors you want, which is what I did to create this look. So here are the swatches of the first two rows here. My arm is too small, I couldn't fit the entire palette on one arm. But as you can see, the first five is that more blue toned row, and then the last five are that more warm tone row, and then here on my other arm I have that more reddish purpley row, the very bottom row. So one thing I would like to mention about my swatches is that you can see my swatches are a little bit more sheer, they look a little bit patchy on my arm. That's because I use a very light swipe and I apply it to my arm because I do want to see the true pigment that's going to apply to my eyes. I think a lot of times you get tricked because people really dig in and kind of try to get that full color payoff so you can really see the color. I more so like to see the pigment payoff so that I can see if I can build it on my eyes. I don't like, especially dark matte shadows, to be really pigmented. I'd prefer them to be buildable. That makes them easier to work with, and that means they're going to be more blendable. They all swatched very creamy and buttery. I didn't have any issues. These eyeshadows are a little bit on the powdery side, so you do have to tap your brush off, but I don't mind because great pigmentation showed up on my eyes and I didn't not have any issues. You can create some very interesting looks with this palette because the color selection is very unique, but you can also create very wearable everyday colors because you do have creams and browns and light browns and all of these different shades that you can create a very simple work-friendly look with. I personally love all matte looks. I'm loving the all matte look that I'm rocking right now, but of course you can pair this with a shimmery eyelid color. I think if you have this in a palette that's all shimmers, that's all you need because you can create so many looks with these colors. I think it's a really great selection, and I'm such a brown girl. I find like browns like this and this and a cream color to be essential in my collection, and this palette has it, and then way more to get creative if you're ever feeling creative. I mean, so that being said, there really isn't much more I can say about this palette. The formula is beautiful, the packaging is genius, the color scheme, I mean, it's unique, I'm digging it, I don't have anything like it in my collection. I really do feel that this palette is very unique in my collection, but that being said, I do have almost all of the Natasha Denona palettes. And I was looking at the Tropic palette, and there are some very similar tones. As you can see, this is a more brownie, pinky, neutral row. This palette has more rich neutrals than this palette does. This one's a little bit more peachy, this one's a little bit more rich. Anyways, I love this way more than the Tropic palette because I love her matte formula, and not a single shadow in this palette falls short. And it's $129. No palette should fall short. And so she really did a great job with this palette. I find it inspiring. I find the quality to be great. And I just find it a great addition to my collection because I do feel the colors in it and the color combinations are very unique and user-friendly. So really quickly, I'm just gonna go into how I did this look and what I used. I started off with the shade Aya, whatever that is. It's a matte cream color, and I just kind of put that all over my lid as my base color. The color names in these are really hard to pronounce, but I went with Amhara. Anyways, that's from the bottom row, and I just applied that all over my crease as my transition color. I then went in with that reddish orange color, Tribe, and I put that in my outer corner and blended that all throughout my crease. I took Thorn, which is that matte chocolate brown color, and I blended that in my outer corner, and I am very picky about my chocolate browns. I don't like when they don't blend out, but this one blended very beautifully, very smooth, very creamy. I then took Desert Date, and I put that all over my lid. This shadow is a bit soft, it's a bit powdery, but it applied beautifully. And then I just did what I had to do on my lower lash line, and that's how I got this look. I really do love this look. I am looking to post more looks possibly on my Instagram and maybe a tutorial here on my YouTube channel. All right, with that being said, I am going to finish up this review. I hope you guys found it helpful, and if you have any questions, comment down below. I will be happy to answer them. That's all I have for today, so remember to subscribe to my channel, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye.